One of the biggest country hits of all times is El Paso, written and recorded by Marty Robbins in 1959. It became the number one song in America. Later, we'll hear more about this big hit, but first, let's go back to the beginning. Marty Robbins was born on September 26, 1925, and grew up near Glendale, Arizona. Marty recalls those early days and his love of Gene Autry movies.
I always wanted to be a singing cowboy. When I was a little kid, like 9, 10, and 11 years old, it only cost 10 cents to get in the movie, and you could get a big sack of popcorn for 5 cents also. Well, I would go in at 12:45 when it opened, and I would stay till Gene Autry was through that night. He had done something that was real great, so they wanted to run him for sheriff of this little town. And so he climbed up into a wagon. I don't know where the guitar came from, but he got it. He said, "I'm not much at making speeches. I guess I'll just have to sing for you."
I'm back in the saddle again, out where a friend is a friend, where the longhorn cattle feed on the lonely jimson weed. Back in the saddle again.
Marty Robbins served in the Navy in World War II, and during that time he learned how to play guitar and learned to love Hawaiian music. In 1947, after he returned to Glendale, Arizona, he began to sing in local clubs and landed a radio show. He thought it beat working for a living. This led to a 15-minute TV show 4 days a week called Country Caravan. One of the guest stars on that show was Little Jimmy Dickens.
When you walk up to a jukebox and you slip a nickel in, you can bet your bottom dollar that the record starts to spin. You'll hear a fiddle and a guitar with a honky-tonking sound. It's that hillbilly fever's going round.
Dickens liked what he heard, and he helped Marty land a deal with Columbia Records in 1951. Here's how Marty remembers it.
Jimmy Dickens stood and listened to me. He said he liked my singing, and he was going to speak to CBS Records when he got to California. He did. CBS came to Phoenix, Arizona, listened to me, and signed me up.
We're traveling down two different roads in worlds so far apart. You want me, yet there's something else before me in your heart. You're wanting me to change my life the way you're living yours. But I can't change, I see no way you wanted me before. If you don't want me like I am, then please don't pity me. If you can't change a little bit, then why not set me free? If we can't live together, then it's best we live apart. You go your way and I'll go mine. We'll both make brand new stars. Do it seems we'll never get along. With you believing like you do, you say I live so wrong. But I can't change my way of life, I've lived it much too long. You'll either take me like I am, or I'll go on alone. So either say you want my love, or take the way you live. Remember though, before you get, you've gotta learn to give. So if it's changed my life or go, then go it's gonna be. 'Cause I can't change my life when you want something more than me.
By 1955, rock and roll was becoming the music of choice in America with hits by Elvis, Chuck Berry, Fats Domino, and others. Because of this musical trend, Columbia released an album called Rockin' Rollin' Robbins.
Well, that's all right, Mama. That's all right for you. That's all right, Mama. Just any way you do, that's all right.
That's all right. That's all right, Mama. Any way you do. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You done started back doing the things you used to do. Well, as I was motivating over the hill, saw Maybelline in a coupe de ville. Cadillac rolling on an open road, nothing outrun my V8-4. Cadillac doing about 95, bumper to bumper, rolling side to side. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You done started back doing the things you used to do.
Marty's second number one song came in 1956. Melvin Inslee, a fellow performer on the Grand Ole Opry, played Marty a song he had written. Marty liked the song, Columbia Records liked the song, and they recorded it with both Marty Robbins and Guy Mitchell. Both versions became smash hits.
Well, I never felt more like singing the blues, because I never thought that I'd ever lose your love, dear. Why'd you do me this way? Well, I never felt more like crying all night, because everything's wrong and nothing ain't right. Singing the blues.